Well, I think it's very important for all of us to recognize and understand our roots so as to understand ourselves better and effectively others. I honestly, truly, and kind of strongly feel that till you don't respect yourself, you won't be able to respect others. And eventually, that may be an obstacle in a world that we are trying to create, which ideally, an ideal world for me would be a world which is one without borders, where the whole world is a space for us to live in, and where each one of us is a world citizen. So in that endeavor, I'm trying to learn the roots and the belonging where I come from, which is Gujarat, understand it better by through the works I feel of the literary writers and the poets who have done some wonderful work over the years, and through them I'm attempting to know my history, know my culture, my tradition, roots better. And I hope all the Gujaratis and even the non-Gujaratis for that matter will have a lot to know about the Gujarati culture, tradition, heritage, and some fine writing. And today I have chosen to talk to you all about Kanhaiyalal Munshiji. He's written some great work, and one of his most popular work, arguably so, is Gujarat No Nath. The English translation of which I have is called The Master of Gujarat. It's by Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. They have published this. Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan was first established by Munshiji. There's gold in many languages, and I think this is gold I'm holding here from the Gujarati literary world. And before you read his work, which I insist you must, I'm going to read a little about Munshiji himself, so that I'm kind of sure that that will get you even more interested. This is from the introduction. I'm reading certain paragraph from it. It says that he was a graduate of the Baroda College. He was a student of Sri Aurobindo. He worked with Mahatma Gandhi mostly as editor of two journals, that is Navjeevan and Young India. They were known better as Mahatma's journal than as Munshi's, and his style was influenced by the Gandhian spirit of simplicity and directness. Though Munshiji also entered into many heated debates with Mahatma, he was Mahatma's friend. Munshiji began his career as a lawyer, but unlike the Mahatma, he became one of the most successful advocates practicing in the Bombay High Court. A little more about Munshiji, some really interesting aspects and facts about him, which will give you an idea what kind of a writer he is. Most of Munshiji's literary work was done in the mother tongue, Gujarati, a language which he loved, cherished, and enriched, as few have or could have done. Now, from the publisher's note, I find this very interesting. The publisher says that he was a champion of English. Munshiji was also an ardent lover and protagonist of Hindi in the 30s. He was the co-editor, along with renowned Hindi literary genius Shri Premchand, of the celebrated Hindi magazine Hans. It is said that Premchand ji later prefixed Munshi to his name to commemorate this harmonious co-editorship. Munshi Premchand is the name he took up. Munshi ji was the president of the Hindi Sahitya Sammelan. This is Kanhaiyalal Munshiji, of the Hindi Sahitya Sammelan in 1945. Munshi ji firmly held the view that Hindi should become the national language of India, but with the willing consent of the non-Hindi speaking people. I'm going to close this now with the publisher's last para where he says that a line of prayer from the Rig Veda, which was close to Munshiji's heart and which is the Bhavan's credo, is let noble thoughts come to us from every side. Now I'm going to read the first para of Gujarat Nonath, the English translation of which is Master of Gujarat, just to give you a little taste of his writing. Won't justify the wonderful work, but you'll get an idea. Chapter 1, on a cold dark night. It was a dark and very cold winter night in the year 1154. In the deep dark silence of the night, even the sedate sounds of the river Saraswati flowing nearby seemed terrifying. A cold and humid breeze blew in from the river. It was a night on which one would wish to be warmly snuggled up at home or with the beloved. And yet a few hundred people were camping that night on the banks of the Saraswati across from Patan. A few isolated groups of people had lit small bonfires to chase away the bitter cold. Some were trying to snatch a little sleep near the fires, while others were content to huddle over them in the dark. The unsteady fires threw macabre shadows all around, making the night even more terrifying, almost as if phantoms or spirits were dancing eerily around the fires. Now I'm going to read the original text written by Munshiji in Gujarati. Chapter 1, Saraswati na Tire. Samvat 1154 na શિયાળાની એક રાતે કડકડતી ઠંડી પડતી હતી. પાસે વહેતી સરસ્વતીના નીરનો ગંભીર રવ રાત્રિને શૂન્યતામાં ભયજનક થતો હતો. તેના શિખરોથી શીતળ થયેલો પવન શિયાળો ભૂલાવી ચોમાસાના સિકલનું ભાન કરાવતો હતો. રાત્રિ એવી હતી કે ઘરને ખૂણે કે પ્રિયતમાના પાશમાં જ પડી રહેવું પસંદ પડે. છતાં 400-500 માણસ પાટણને સામે કિનારે ઉઘાડામાં પડ્યા હતા. છૂટી છવાઈ તાપણી કરી ટાળ ઉડાડવાનો પ્રયત્ન કેટલાક કરી રહ્યા હતા અને બાકીના તાપણીઓની આસપાસ સૂઈ ગયા હતા અથવા તો સુવાનો પ્રયત્ન કરતા હતા. ગણ્યા ગાંઠ્યા ઊંઘવાનો વિચાર નહીં હોવાથી તૂટ્યું વાળી બેસી રહ્યા હતા. અંધારામાં તાપણીના અસ્થિર વળતા વિચિત્ર છાયાઓ નાખી રાત્રિને વધારે ભયંકર બનાવતા હતા. આખો દેખાવ જાણે પિશાચોનું સંમેલન હોય એવો લાગતો હતો. સો દેટ વોઝ જસ્ટ ધ ફર્સ્ટ પેરેગ્રાફ ફ્રોમ મુનશીજીઝ ગ્રેટ વર્ક, એન્ડ આઈ ઇન્સિસ્ટ દેટ ઓલ ઓફ યુ રીડ ધીસ બુક. આઈ એમ ગોઈંગ ટુ રીડ ઇટ માય સેલ્ફ. And the Gujaratis, the non-Gujaratis, of course, know of this version, the Master of Gujarat, which I just read out from. So please read it. And the Gujaratis can read either the Gujarati version or the English version if they please. And this book promises to give you a lot of wealth in terms of knowledge, and it'll enlighten you to a large degree. So I'm told by near and dear ones. So happy reading and happy celebration of the Gujarati culture and tradition. Thank you. 93.5 FM. 93.5 bajate raho.